My name is Josh. Full name is Joshua Sabio, and I recently graduated with honors in psychology. To be honest with you, psychology wasn't really my first pick. It was accounting and finance. Psychology was just one of my electives, but I switched degrees because I found it really interesting. I found the intersection between mind and behavior really, really interesting. And now I feel like there's a lot more meaning to research than I originally thought. So there's that. I actually, in third year, one of my units was called Sensory and Perception Neuropsychology. And I think it was Jason Bell was the lecturer for one of the lectures, and it was on color perception. And I was just fascinated by how our perceptions and our view of the world can be traced back to the mechanisms inside our mind, inside this physical, like, jelly-like thing inside our brains. Like, I thought that was really amazing. Color perception. I sent an email to Nick because on his profile, it said that he did psychophysics. And I was really interested in psychophysics because I thought the science part of psychology was, like, the most interesting part. And then we just got to talking, and yeah, just cascaded from that. The biggest challenge was probably the beginning. But once you get into, like, a routine of looking through articles, of figuring out what analysis to do, it gets a lot easier. So I think that the peak of difficulty is in the right at the beginning of the year, when you sort of, like, getting your footing, and you're not sure, like, which articles to go into, and then what topics to research. But it does get better. That's all I can say. The most important thing that I learned during my honors was probably communication, not just communication with just through, like, a one-to-one conversation, but being able to communicate science to an audience that can understand it, so that everyone can access the knowledge and the information that you hold here. Because if no one understands you, like, you can be really technical. If no one understands you, it's just in your head. The information just exists with you. It doesn't exist out there in the real world. I think communication is the most important part, one of the most important things that I've learned this year. If I could change one thing from my honors year last year, I would probably get into programming a lot sooner, because it just made a huge impact on how I ran my analyses and how I conducted the data throughout the year. So because I'd only started programming 2 months before for the year started, I sort of just learned on the job. And if I had that prior knowledge, if I had the knowledge that I have now in terms of programming and statistics and analysis back then, even before I started my thesis, I think it would have gone a lot smoother. The strategies that I use to help cope with the stress of an honors thesis, probably just having a routine. Having a routine really helps. Exercise, just looking after yourself, because it's really, like, when you hone in on, like, a task, right? It's really easy to stop looking after yourself, but you need to look after yourself. You're like a little baby that you need to look after. So, remember to, like, drink your water, like, exercise, like, eat your fruits and vegetables, just basically self-care. Never neglect self-care, even when you're going through, like, stressful times during your thesis. The lead-up to submission was a little anxiety-ridden, And I think that's natural, because considering that this is a year's worth of work and you don't want to disappoint anyone, especially not yourself, because you know how hard you worked for this. But when you finally press that submit button on Sonia, it's a huge relief. And just for a moment before you go on to postgrad, before you go apply for PhDs, you can breathe. And I think that's you need to capitalize on those moments. The advice that I would give honors students is, first and foremost, have a really good relationship with your supervisor. Like, this is someone who's going to be your number one go-to for the entire year. And if you don't have a good relationship from the get-go, you're going to have a really, really bad year. I can just say that now. Brush up on your stats and your data. Maybe learn like a programming language or two before the year starts. It really helps, and it really helps assert your independence, so you don't have to go to your supervisor to run the analyses every single time. Aim to read an article once every 3 days. Like, try to keep a routine, like a consistent routine of reading articles. But don't do it so that you just skim over articles. That's not the point of that. It's just building a routine of basically doing research. I would personally do it again, because I just had a really great time. It was hard, right? But it was good, because it was a challenge. And because the challenge was a little directionless, but in that you got to pick your struggle, you got to pick which direction you wanted to take your research in and how detailed you wanted it to be. I found that really liberating. as a student who we spent 3 years doing exams and doing assessments and tests, being able to take control of what you learn is really freeing. So yeah, I would do it all over again. In 5 years' time, when I wake up and I start my 9-to-5 or whatever, I just want to be able to learn, whether it's like it's through a coffee with like a fellow academic, or attending like a talk, or researching a specific topic myself while I'm writing an article. I just want to be able to learn something new every single day. That's where I want to be in 5 years, and I want to be in where the intellectual traffic is to be in that environment.